Hi, what causes psychogenic non-epileptic seizures? Is it just anxiety, depression, and PTSD? Is it just stress? Well, the answer is no. And the neuroscience and the new advancement have been shown that this is not the case. And there are real changes that happens in the brain in psychogenic non-epileptic seizures. Welcome to the psychogenic non-epileptic seizures series. And in this series, I will explain all the factors and everything about PNES. And in the first two videos, I explain what is PNES and what is the diagnosis and how it is made. And I will leave a link down in the description below. The most important thing is that PNES is a real condition and there are real changes that happens in the brain. Neuroscience has shown that there is an imbalance in the networks of conflict resolution. For example, there is a direct connection between the emotional areas, the amygdala and the limbic system, and the motor cortex, like where the movement happens. So there'll be emotional conflicts in the brain, and then that will go directly to the motor cortex and cause the movements and the psychogenic seizures. And there is imbalance between those areas, and that will lead to the movements that we experience. And also there is a difference in the areas of the brain, even like there is a difference in the thickness and the structure. So now it is a real condition with real changes in the brain that we even can see in scans and even with functional MRI and volumetric new analysis study. Here's how it works. You have a conflict. There is something bothering you. So, and this will go inside. And some people like you, they're very sensitive, they're very compassionate, they don't want to hurt others and just internalize things inside, and they keep repressing them and it keeps accumulating inside, one after another after another. Some people will deal with that by just lashing out, getting angry, saying bad words and being mean to others, but that's not you and not people with psychogenic narcoleptic seizures. The careless ones will not come to my clinic, I will not see them, but the compassionate ones will do. So it's kind of like it keeps accumulating on your chest and it keeps accumulating inside, and it's kind of like a dam that keeps filling up with water again and again and again until it reaches a breaking point, and either it breaks the dam and get out, or we channel it out in a healthy way and get a torpedo to make electricity out of that. And then the way that the brain deals with that, the networks that is imbalanced, it will push all of that complex repressed feelings and emotions and conflicts into motor, and will kind of induce those motor changes and shaking and all of those seizures. And then the brain is powerful and it is capable of inducing real physical change. Think of yourself, like you have, you're standing up and giving a speech in front of lots of people. So, well, good luck with that. So when I do sometimes like a stand up, then your arms will start shaking, your heart start to race and you feel sweaty and all of that, like your butterfly in the stomach. All of those are real physical changes that happens, but the cause is not like you're having a heart attack or you're having a stroke. It is that there is a conflict in the brain. Are you going to do good or not? And that will rush the fight or flight response, and that will induce those real physical changes. And this is the same mechanism of how the brain behaves and how the brain acts in non-epileptic seizures, to the best of our understanding so far. And for more insight, I discussed with the world expert on non-epileptic seizure, Dr. Kurt LaFrance.
We still don't have a definitive known cause. What we can say is that there are many commonalities in people who have psychogenic non-epileptic seizures. So one of the ways that I describe it to people is psychogenic non-epileptic seizures are a type of conversion disorder or a functional neurological disorder that are a neurological manifestation of an underlying psychological conflict or stressor. Another way to look at it is by saying that it's a behavioral presentation of abnormal neuronal networks or brain circuits. About, depending on which study you're looking at, there's anywhere from 30% up to 80% of people report some type of a history of trauma. Now, a lot of people assume, oh, well, trauma, that must mean something bad that happened when I was a kid. It doesn't have to be only as a kid. So in fact, not only do children, is there a history of some child events, there's also a report of adults who've had events. So for instance, somebody who might be in an accident or who might be exposed to some type of what we call a life event or a loss, that can actually be a factor that's associated with non-epileptic seizures.
It's very important to know that psychogenic non-epileptic seizure is not anxiety, depression, or PTSD. And it is very important to differentiate between those two conditions because they are different and will not do any good if we combine them together. We know that patients with psychogenic non-epileptic seizures, they can have comorbid, means it happens together, anxiety, depression, and PTSD, and in 50% of the time. And they have sometimes, like 50% of the time, they do not have comorbid anxiety, depression, or PTSD condition. And it is important for recovery of PNES and non-epileptic seizures to treat underlying depression, anxiety, and PTSD. It's kind of like that is a noise in the background. If, remember, if like trying to remember a novel and somebody's like banging on the door behind you and you cannot like focus, and this is how the anxiety depression is creating some distraction in the system, and without treating them it is very difficult to get better with PNES. Sometimes there is a role for trauma.
Not everybody who had something traumatic happen in their life developed PTSD or non-epileptic seizures or some other form of a conversion disorder. Also, not everybody who has a conversion disorder has a history of prior lifetime trauma. So it's not a one-to-one correlation.
Regardless of history of trauma, most of the people assume that if you have psychogenic non-epileptic seizures, it has to be somebody raped you, or like there has to be some trauma as a child or sexual trauma. And it turns that this is not the case in the majority of cases. About like half of the patients did not have any history of trauma, or they can have a trauma as an adult or different traumatic life experiences, not necessarily as a children, not necessarily to little girls, not necessarily to females. It can be to males, it can be to anyone, and everyone's trauma is different. Also, it can be the biology of the brain and the build of the brain is more susceptible to trauma. So sometimes people can have traumatic life experiences, and then the way they react to the trauma is how the condition evolves. Because some people will have traumatic life experiences and very adverse life event, and they don't have anything as a consequence. I mean, they get distressed, but they don't necessarily develop non-epileptic seizures or any other complications afterward. And some people, like little trauma, such as somebody's cat dies as a child, that can be so traumatic to somebody, and because there is like some emotional attachment and there are like some deep connections between them and their pet or their cat or their mom, and that can be very traumatic and leads to more complication down the line. And some people, like, they cannot pinpoint one trauma in their life, and it is okay because sometimes traumas can be very deep, very old, very hidden, and as in the heat of the trauma you will not have anything, but later on, like 10-20 years later, the trauma will come back. And sometimes like very trivial things that you do not know that they can be the trigger of your bad experiences or life experiences, they just surface out when it actually happens when you are happy and everything is good, not when you are in the heat of the trauma. And sometimes there are like multiple small traumas that keep accumulating until this like last trauma that really the straw that broke the camel's back, as we say. And this was the kind of like the obvious trauma, but there is like a build of bad environment that led to non-epileptic seizures, not just like that one single trauma. There's very interesting research that found that physical trauma and hit to the head, a traumatic brain injury, can cause non-epileptic seizures. And a prominent study done by Dr. Kurt LaFrance's group showed that the traumatic brain injury can cause non-epileptic seizures. And this theory is called like double hit phenomena, where the physical trauma is the hit to the brain and the psychological trauma with that hit, all combined together, they increase the chances and develop non-epileptic seizure. And people who had traumatic brain injury, they have like 3 times more chances of developing non-epileptic seizure. At the end of the day, you might say that, if I was not abused by this person, or if I did not have this trauma, if I did not fall and broke my head or something like that, then my life would be different. Well, it can be true that this trauma is the cause, or it can be that your brain biology and the brain susceptibility is what puts you at a higher risk of reaction to those traumatic life experiences. And sometimes it can be different traumas that will lead to the same end result. So I had a patient, like, you know, she had like an accident with like the bus only hit a stop and her head hit the chair in front, and that developed non-epileptic seizures. Like, oh my God, if I was not on the bus that day, I mean, probably she would have any other traumatic experience, a bully in school or something that can cause the same end result. So there are multiple factors that play a role: the biology of the brain, the genetics, the nurturing, the family environment, the social interactions, the friends, the the network, all of that, they are complex networks and complex factors that all combined together, they can, at the end, lead to an epileptic seizure. You might ask, why me? Well, that's a legit question. Because why me? Why you are having non-epileptic seizures and others are not having this? I don't know. The answer is complex, but probably because that's who you are. You are compassionate. You are caring. You're very big-hearted. And that's why, you know, you develop that. Because you don't want to hurt others. And kind of that's how your brain dealt with it and came out as physical seizures and physical shaking and physical symptoms. We don't want to change you. We don't want to change who you are. Because you are amazing the way you are. You are caring. You are compassionate. Other people are careless. We don't need them. We need you the way you are. And we will help you the way you are to overcome this and get the best out of you. And the good news here is that we have lots of treatments for non-epileptic seizures, and new studies have shown very effective new treatments that we will explain in details in the next part of this series in this video. And stay healthy and see you in the next one. Salam.